How to go from building slow, old-school UIs with loading indicators to optimistic UIs that load instantly in Next.js 14. Before we look at how to build fast UIs with the useOptimistic hook and server actions, let's have a look at how we typically build UIs with Next.js and React, or the old-school way of doing things. Here is my to-dos component in Next.js 14, and this is a server component which calls the getToDos function on the server side. The getToDos function makes a fetch request to the Next.js get API endpoint, and then it passes the results of that fetch request to my to-do list component, which is a client component. In my to-do list client component, I'm using the useClient directive to tell Next.js to render this as a client component, and I'm destructuring to-dos as initial to-dos. Then I'm using the useSWR hook to display data from the props when the to-do list component is rendered. And when I toggle a to-do, I set the loading state to true. Then I make a fetch request to toggle the to-do, mutate the data, and specify my cache key, and set the loading state to false again. When I mutate the data with my cache key, Next.js will revalidate the data. And the way this works is that Next.js will reload the components on the server side from the to-dos component, and the to-dos will then be passed to the client component without reloading the entire page. And this results in a typical UI that many of us are used to, where we have a loading indicator and a UI that is quite slow to use. Let's look at how we can build modern UIs with Next.js using server actions and the useOptimistic hook. To build optimistic UIs, we don't need to use server actions. We can simply use fetch together with the useOptimistic hook to get the performance benefits of optimistic UIs without using server actions. However, server actions have a number of key benefits and is the preferred way of performing data mutations in Next.js. Let's refactor from using fetch on the client side to using server actions. Before we do, let's look at how things currently work. The onToggleClient handler currently calls the path API endpoint via fetch directly. So if I toggle a to-do, we can see a patch request followed by a get request. The patch request is made in the onToggleClient handler function, and the get request is made via the useSWR hook after the data is mutated. Let's refactor the to-do list component's onToggleClient handler function to call a server action instead of calling fetch directly from the client. To do this, I'll create a new folder called server actions and create a file called todoToggle.ts. Then I'll use the useServer directive and create my toggleTodo function. And in this function, I've added a delay of 500 milliseconds. Then I connect to my Mongo cloud instance and update the todo on the Mongo instance. I added a log so that we know when the server action is executed. And finally, I revalidate the tag. I'll open the to-do list props and add onToggleServerAction as a property. Then, in the to-do list component, I'll destructure the onToggleServerAction property, and in the to-dos component, I'll pass down the toggleToDoServerAction to the to-do list component. Then, in the toggleClientHandler function, I'll remove the fetch code and simply call the server action. Back in the browser, if I toggle a to-do item, we'll no longer see any patch requests. Instead, we'll see a post request. All server actions are made via a post request. And following the post request, we'll see the get fetch request, which is made via the useSWR hook after the server action is called, just like before. Now, let's migrate the onAddClientHandler function to use a server action. I'll create an addTodo server action where I do some basic server-side validation, create the to-do, and revalidate the tag. Then in the to-do list component, I'll remove the fetch code and call the server action. Then I'll destructure the onAddServerAction property in the to-do list component and add onAddServerAction as a property in the to-do list props file. And finally, in the to-dos component, I'll pass the addToDoServerAction to the to-do list component. Finally, I'll update the onDeleteClientHandler function in the to-do list component to use a server action. I'll remove the fetch code, then add a new server action, and update the to-do list props by adding an onDeleteServerAction property. Back in the browser, If I delete a to-do, we can see a post request with the to-do ID as the payload, followed by a get fetch request again. Now that we've covered server actions, let's look at doing optimistic UI updates by updating the user interface immediately before mutating the data on the server, and rolling back UI updates if there were errors while attempting to mutate data on the server. We'll use the useOptimistic hook to do this. In my to-do list component, I'll remove everything we don't need anymore. We don't need the fetcher anymore. We no longer need the useState hook to set to-dos. We no longer need the useSWR hook. The useEffect, along with all these conditional statements, are no longer needed. So that can go too. And now I'll remove all instances of setIsLoading. The spinner component is no longer needed, so that can go too. We also no longer need the mutate function from the useSWR hook. So I'll remove the import along with the unused React imports. And then I'll remove all the mutate invocations. Now we can implement the useOptimistic hook. I'll implement the useOptimistic hook and take in to-dos. Then I'll import the useOptimistic hook and remove the initial to-dos alias. And finally, I'll make sure we map over optimistic to-dos instead of to-dos. Back in the browser, let's check that the to-dos still load. Now let's change the onToggleClientHandler function to toggle to-dos optimistically. I'll create a new array called updatedToDos with the toggled to-do item. And then I'll wrap the setOptimisticToDos stateSetter function call in the startTransition function and import the startTransition hook from React. The startTransition hook marks the optimisticToDos state update as non-urgent and allows Next.js to prioritize UI updates like user interactions over this update. It improves the responsiveness of the app. Back in the browser, let's see if the to-dos are updated optimistically. I'll toggle all three to-dos, and we can see that the UI now updates optimistically. In other words, the UI updates first, and then the data is updated on the server, as you can see in the network tab on the right. Let's see how the useOptimistic hook handles errors. I'll open the toggle to-do server action and throw an error after a 700 millisecond delay. Back in the browser, if I toggle a to-do, we can see that the to-do is toggled optimistically, and then an error is returned after 700 milliseconds, and the UI changes are rolled back. Next, I'll update the delete to-do functionality in the onDeleteClientHandle function to delete to-dos optimistically. I'll create a new array that excludes the to-do item that we want to delete, and then I'll wrap the setOptimisticToDos stateSetter function with the startTransition function, just like we did in the onToggleClientHandler function earlier. Before we test this in the browser, I'll add an 800 millisecond delay in the deleteTodo server action. Back in the browser, let's see if the to-dos are now deleted optimistically. I'll add four new tasks, and then I'll delete them. And we can see that the UI is updated immediately, followed by the server actions. And finally, let's update the onAddClientHandler function to add to-dos optimistically. Adding to-dos optimistically is going to work slightly differently. Let's have a look at the to-dos interface. We've got an ID property, and usually the UI is updated with a newly added to-dos ID. This ID value is used so that we can toggle or delete to-dos via the icons on the to-do list. But because we're adding to-dos optimistically, and because the ID property is mandatory, we're going to add a temporary ID. So I'll create a new variable called temp ID and prefix it with temp ID and suffix it with the current date value to ensure that each temp ID value is unique. Then I'll create a new temp to-do object which sets the value of the ID property to the temp ID. And then I'll create a new state setter function called set loading states to keep track of the temp IDs and set the loading state of the temp ID. Then I'll update the optimistic to-dos by wrapping the setOptimisticToDos stateSetter function call in the setTransition function again, just like we did in the previous examples. Then To show you how these updates work in the browser, I'm going to add an ID property to the list element, and then I'll create an isOptimisticToDo variable to determine if the to-do is an optimistic to-do, or if it's a to-do from the server. And then I'll only render the to-do icons if it's not an optimistic to-do. In the addToDoServer function, I'll add a 1.5 second delay so that we can track how the temp IDs are set by the useOptimistic hook. Back in the browser, let's add a new to-do. And in Chrome Developer Tools, I'll inspect the to-do list. If I add a new to-do item, we can see that the optimistic to-do has an ID that is prefixed with temp ID, and the toggle and delete icons are hidden. Then, 1.5 seconds later, after the to-do is returned from the server, the to-do is updated with the ID from the server, and the toggle and delete icons are now visible. There's still a few improvements we can make to the addToDo functionality to make the UI updates even faster. Currently, while adding a to-do, the add button is disabled for the duration of the server call, and this blocks the UI. Let's update this so that the UI is not blocked. In the addToDo component, I'll change the handleSubmit function by removing the setSubmitting state setting function. Then on the button in the addToDo component, I'll remove the functionality that disables the button if the submission state is submitting. Back in the browser, if I add a to-do, the add button is no longer disabled while a to-do is being added. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you found this video helpful.